Tonight I've actually managed to get my first real monitor program working on my 6502 breadboard computer. This is a Benita style breadboard computer. I've added a 4x4 keypad on here with an encoder chip, and the idea is that I've got a self-contained computer that I can program in 6502 machine code and run programs. I'm going to now enter the world's most boring program, but this is my first program. Now, you've got a shift key here. This button here enables you to step forwards and backwards through memory locations. So if I step forwards and backwards here, you'll notice different memory locations appearing on the LCD display here. So that's location 0300, and the contents are 00, and the symbol next to it is just an ASCII representation of the contents of that memory location. I'm going to start entering my program. It's not Moodle, it's very simple. You just enter the hexadecimal number on the keypad. My first instruction is going to be A9, which is load A. So I type in A9. I don't need to do anything. It's already loaded that into that memory location. And I then do Shift D to go to the next location. I enter the next instruction, which is going to be 01. And that's a piece of data. I'm going to load the number 1 into the accumulator, my first two instructions. Let's go to the next memory location. So Shift D to move on to 0302. And at that location, I'm going to enter 20. That's the opcode for jump subroutine. So I'm going to jump to a subroutine, and the subroutine I'm going to jump to is one that's already built into the ROM that is going to clear the LCD display. So if I go to the next memory location, 0303, I need to enter the low part of the address of the subroutine, which I've had to work out from the ROM. I happen to know it's C0. Take my word for it, that's where we want to go to jump to the subroutine. And the high part of the address is 80, because all the ROM addresses, that didn't work very well, did it? Something's gone wrong. Let's just try that again. So 0302 is 20. 0303 is C0. Oh, it's still there, still working. 80. Okay, something went wrong with the display, but it's all good. And so that's right. So that's going to jump to the place in memory in the ROM that will clear the screen. And 0305, I want a jump instruction because I want to make an infinite loop here. 4C is the opcode for jump. And I just want to jump back here, really. I just want to put it in an infinite loop so it doesn't move on. So I need to put an address in, and the address I want to go to is actually where I am, where the jump instruction was, which was at 05, because it's the address before this one, and it is going to be 03, because all of my user generated programs are all kind of in page 3. They all start at 0300. So let's just go back and check my program before I run it. So it should go A9, which is load A. And I load A with 1, which is the code for clearing the screen. I then do 20, which is the jump subroutine opcode. And the address I go to is kind of back to front, 80CO. So there's the CO, there's the 80. The next instruction is a jump, and the opcode for jump is 4C. And the address I'm going to jump to is 0305, which will be backwards. So we'll get 05. Oh, got a mistake there. That should be 03. Right. Good job, we checked it. So let's just check it again from the beginning. Go back to the beginning of my program. It should go A9, 01, 20, C0, 80, 4C, 05, 03. That's all good. Right, and I need to run the program. So to do that, I need to Shift and press A. That's my go button. So Shift and press A, and we should see the LCD clear. It works. So I have entered a machine code program on my self-contained computer just using opcodes on the hexadecimal keypad, and I've run it using the hex keypad as well. So I'm really happy. I've actually achieved my aim much quicker than I thought I would. I've written a really simple monitor program. It's not very long at all, that enables you to enter machine code programs on a keypad and run them. And if you want to break out of that loop and go back and kind of stop it and reset it, all you do is you just press the reset button on the processor, jumps you back into the monitor program. There we go. We're back at 0300 address, and my program is still there, so I can still step through it and I can modify it. Not bad. I'm quite pleased with that.